It's Exhibition Football on ESPN. The Broncos come in with a secondary that looks like they can be taken for a ride early and often. To get the win, they need to be in rare form today. They will be going up against a team with similar strengths versus the Chargers, who come in with a dominating secondary. They possess the ability to shut down most middle to deep passing attacks and completely disrupt offensive coordinators' game plans. Let's see how it transpires as we go to San Diego with Dan Stevens and Peter O'Keefe. Welcome. It's time for some exhibition football here at Qualcomm Stadium. I'm Dan Stevens, and with me, as always, is Peter O'Keefe. Well, Peter, tell us what we have in store for us.
Oh, these DBs have speed, baby. Greasy speed. They close on the ball like cheetahs. Really, Dan, you can't coach that.
Ryan McNeil
comes in shutting down his side of the secondary. Don't make a mistake in his direction because he'll punish you for it. And looking over to the team warming up, we see another awesome cover guy.
Delta O'Neal
comes in giving the all-important presence in the secondary. He makes quarterbacks uncomfortable, and his stats are consistent with that.
During his career on defense, he's averaged 2 tackles and an interception every 3rd game or so.
Okay, Peter, now let's go to midfield for the coin toss.
He was tail.
They call tail. It is head.
The Chargers elect to receive the kickoff. Gets ready to get this game underway. It's off. White gets it deep. Tackle at the 23-yard line.
First down, Chargers.
Well, let's see how their offense fares here.
First and 10. They line up with their tight end, White. The 5-year man out of Eastern Michigan. Peter, let's look at the Chargers' starting offense. Let's begin with the offensive line.
Corey Raymer shows up to play on every down, Dan, protecting his quarterback at any cost.
Next up, the receiving core.
Curtis Conway adds a lot to this pack of receivers. In his career, he's averaged 51 yards on 3 catches a game.
And lastly, the man who calls the plays and the guys who back him up.
LaDainian Tomlinson gives this trio its punch. During his career as a back, he's averaged 77 yards and just under a touchdown a game.
Okay, back to the action. Second and 10.
Let's not give me anything. Nothing, baby. Swing.
Conway in motion. That will bring up 3rd and long.
Hayward is really handing these guys their helmets. That's a nice stop there on 2nd down. Nice hit for some lost yards.
Good defense, Peter. I like that. Your helmet, sir. It's 3rd and about 13. Just one man in the backfield. Looney in the back. That will bring up 4th and short. Peter, let's run down the Broncos defense. We'll start off with the D-line.
Trevor Price and his men deliver knockout blows to the offensive line all game long.
Up now are the linebackers.
Al Wilson pulls together all the loose ends and reads the quarterback's eyes like a book.
Finally, Peter, the secondary.
Delta O'Neal flies around the field and gets in receivers' faces.
Let's get back to the game.
Yeah.
Bennett will punt it away after a three and out.
Coverage on this one. Look how fast they drop the return man. He doesn't stand a chance. Ow. Goes down immediately.
Perfectly played by this punt squad. And the special coach is congratulating his men on the sideline.
Well, the defense did their job and forced a three and out. Now it's the offense's turn.
Ball at the 28-yard line. Run down the Broncos offense. Up first are the big guys, the offensive line.
Tom Nalen keeps the quarterback healthy, and he and his line are ready to go.
Next up are the receivers.
Rod Smith leads this squad, putting on a big show for the fans. In his career, he's averaged 64 yards on four catches a game.
Last but not least, we have these three gentlemen.
Brian Griese puts on a good show with these other two. During his career as quarterback, he's averaged 213 yards and over a touchdown a game.
Back to the field now. All on the 30. Tight end is lined up left side.
McCaffrey has a bit of trouble with this pass, but he gets the job done. Right there. See,
yeah,
see how he turns around to make the step.
Well, a throw like that is tough to snare, Peter, but he takes it in stride.
Indeed he does.
First and 10. They have two tight ends in. Sharp goes in motion.
Nice completion here. Take a look. There's the throw. Right in between the numbers.
He had them lined up just right, and they connected for a decent gain. All at the 48-yard line. Let's look at the Chargers starting defense. Up first is the defensive line.
Marcellus Wiley shows tremendous heart, and the other linemen respect that.
Next up are the linebackers.
Junior Seau is the man who brings the hurt here.
And lastly, the secondary.
Rodney Harrison shadows his receiver like he's glued to him.
Let's get back to the game. Second and about 7 yards. Good takedown by the 5-year man out of Oklahoma State.
Oh, the runner had no place to go but down, and down hard. Great job by the defense on second down.
Third and 8.
He missed it, but if he had caught it, he still would have been short of the markers.
Now Bruin comes in and will punt it away. It's away. White reels in the fair catch.
Tell you what, Dan, they've got a long way to go. Not where you want to start a drive.
Ball on the 13.
That's my ball. You give it back, my ball. Come on. Get down,
at the 13-yard line. They line up in the eye. White in motion. It's the end of the first quarter, and it's still 0-0. Third and 10. They line up with four wideouts. Moody runs back. Goes. First down.
Reese Caldwell turns on the juice and rips this ball down. Watch how he aggressively goes after this. Oh, man.
Oh,
he,
yeah.
He shows great skills there, leaning out to grab that pass.
Well, some receivers would be forced to dive for a ball like that, but he manages to get under the ball. Fantastic play. It's first and 10. They go with the I formation. They go back. Barely gets it off.
Doug Flutie is going to throw an interception, but it happens because of this. Look at the fearsome pressure he has in the backfield. And that's the result right there.
Boy, I'll tell you, they really gave him no place to throw and no time to throw. That pressure really rattled him back there.
Absolutely, Dan. Close game so far, and even though there's plenty of time left, they'd love to score on this drive.
Ball on the 21. It's second and about three. McCaffrey goes in motion. Third down coming up.
Defense makes a key second down stop there, bottling up the middle. Now it comes down to third.
It's third and five. Davis gets it again.
Davis looks like a human bowling ball on this play. Get a load of this run. Catches the defender off guard. He just sends him flying.
A punishing run, Peter. It, you know, these plays like that that really gives the offense a shot in the arm. It's first and goal.
Played that one fast and hard, stopping up the middle and throwing him for a loss.
Second and goal.
Delivers a key stop behind the line of scrimmage. It stops the play cold. Right there, a key stop.
He's really dangerous out there, I gotta tell you. Tough enough to get past the line and then tough enough to bring down his man. We've reached the 2-minute warning.
Let's look at this again and check out the interception. This is great defense.
Peter, fabulous timing. There wasn't much window of opportunity, but he still managed to make that very big play.
Yeah, you can't coach reaction times like that. Well, if they can score on this drive before the half, it could put them in the lead, which is a really big boost going into halftime.
All at the 2-yard line. Ball on the 3. Conway in motion.
Comes out of the gates, breathe and fire, and they make the big play.
Look at this. Oh, ouch.
Down for a safety. What a play.
Richie sets up and will kick it away. Good kick. Cole fields it deep.
Dan, if they can manage to score here, that could really put some pressure on for the second half.
The clock is down to 1 minute, 18 seconds. Barely gets it off. Incomplete.
Alex Morgan had that player's number, including its 4-digit extension, baby. There was no way that pass was getting by him.
Second and 10.
By the pressure on this one.
Yeah, they really put the thumb screws on him, Peter. I think he popped it up a little early.
Yeah, I think you're right. He wanted it just a second more to get rid of that one. Well, if they can score on this drive before the half, it could put them in the lead, which is a really big boost going into halftime.
It's first and 10.
You ain't getting it here.
Two wide receivers on the field. Cleary, they back. Close. Pass falls incomplete.
Jimmy Spencer
managed to make sure that he was positioned between the QB and the receiver on that baby. There was no way that was going to be a completion.
Ball at the 41-yard line. One man back. Cleary gets it off. Out near the sideline. Nice pass by the 18-year man out of Boston College.
Nice pass, and it'll make this third down a whole lot easier coming up.
Third and one. Two tight ends on the field. Cleary, they the Chargers take their first timeout.
Cleary had no trouble zinging that one past the defender. Perfect throw. He couldn't help but catch it.
The ball was sent there, special delivery.
Oh, the receiver didn't even have to sign for it.
The clock shows 59 seconds left. They line up in the shotgun. Cleary, the shotgun. Throws. Stop the clock out at the 9-yard line.
Got some nice yards there off the first down play, and that really opens things up a bit for this next one.
Ball on the 9. Wilson comes up with the stop, his third this afternoon. The Chargers will take a timeout. That's their second.
But he stuffed that run up the middle. There was no way that ball was getting out of the backfield.
Third and 4. Incomplete.
Curtis Conway moved to the outside and was open, but couldn't make the completion.
The clock shows 49 seconds left. Richie can put his team on top with this kick here in the second quarter.
One in pretty easily. Right through.
He could kick those in his sleep.
Sometimes he does, from what I hear. His wife makes him spend a lot of nights on the couch.
The Chargers take the lead with that score, 3-2. Richie lines up, signals, and we're ready for the kickoff. It's away.
Casper
gets the ball.
Well, if they can score on this drive before the half, it could put them in the lead, which is a really big boost going into halftime.
First and 10. Davis with the carry. It's second and about 3. Shot goes in motion. Davis with the ball. They bring up third and short.
Well, this run gets stuffed as well, and it's because the O-line's having real problems getting any real push this drive. They've got to put something together if they want to run the ball.
It's third and two. Harrison is tackled after a superb defensive play to come away with the interception. That will do it for the first half. Score 3-2. Let's go to Clark Dishman in the ESPN studios for a halftime update.
Welcome to the ESPN Halftime Update. Now let's take a look at how the numbers break down from the first half. The Chargers come into halftime having held their own in this game, and it's due in no small part to an effective run-stopping front line. The numbers tell the story here. Rodgers Beckett has so far stepped up against the pass with a total of one interception and two tackles. That makes him our ESPN Hot at the Half player. That will do it for now. I'm Clark Dishman reminding you to tune in to ESPN's postgame show at the conclusion of the game. Let's send you back to Dan and Peter.
Is ready for the second half kickoff. Nice kickoff. Casper catches it in the end zone.
Return of 29. First down, Broncos.
Well, last time they had it, they turned it over on the interception. Let's see if they worked out the kinks here.
Ball at the 26-yard line. They have their tight end to the right.
Took this one off his right guard. Not a bad pickup. Just some nice yards there.
Ball on the 33.
Let's take the yard.
Put this one left side of the line. Pick up a handful to move the markers. Nice job.
First and 10. High formation. Davis will get the ball. Open field wide right. Jammer with the tackle. His first stop of the game.
Took the handoff and went right of center and picked up a handful.
It's second and about 7 yards.
A lot of work to be done for third down.
It's third and 9.
And no first this time. No first place.
No one in the backfield. Reese makes it back. Barely gets it.
Brian Greasy rolled the dice there with a pass and a double coverage. But he got it in there.
Great. You know, that's the kind of decision that does not foster good quarterback-coach relations.
Absolutely. The coach had to be happy with the results, though, you know, once he started breathing regularly.
All at the 48-yard line. Greasy ups back. Throws. It's tipped. McNeil is down after making a great play to come down with the interception.
The Chargers have been scooping up passes like King Kong swatting down by planes. Let's watch.
Well, he's not just knocking them away, Peter. He's catching them, and that really has sent this offense into a tailspin.
Yeah, they'd better get the flight crew in there and,
All right, give it up, Peter.
I'm kind of tapped out on
this.
Yeah, I think so. Sorry. Close game so far, and even though there's plenty of time left, they'd love to score on this drive.
Ball on the 48. They line up with three wideouts.
John Mobley got his body in the way of that one, Dan. It's all about clogging up the passing lanes. You can't coach that.
Second and ten. Number two on the day.
Third down. 10 yards to go.
Third and ten.
Needed to dial that one up a notch, Dan. Didn't quite get there.
Bennett comes in to punt after a three and out. Hounds the punt.
They should stick with passing the football on this drive, Dan. Their numbers on the ground have been lackluster, to say the least.
All at the 3 yard line. They line up with a split backfield. McCaffrey in motion. Ball on the three.
Just crushed his man off the line, and that's what sprung this doozy of a run. Oh, man, that was nice.
Oh, how sweet it is. On speed after that, he gobbled up the yards, Peter. That's like driving down the highway just on the road by yourself.
That sure is.
Broncos have a first after the big run on that last play. Davis is to the right, and we'll see if he can repeat his performance from the last play. McCaffrey goes in motion.
The replay, check his move out. Boy, Dan, that looked painful.
Oh, boy. I think they both came away with a mark or two after that collision, Peter.
I'm sure it was worth it, though. Banging heads is what this game's all about.
Second and less than a yard. Nice job on the outside. Picks up five and the first.
First down.
It's the end of the third quarter. The Chargers currently enjoying a slight advantage, but it's anybody's game, 3-2. It's first and 10.
Perfect example of how to dismantle a run to the outside. Perfect execution by the D.
Second and 14. Go back a play and talk about that tackle. That was a great stop.
Sure thing, Dan. Junior Seau has been voted to 11 consecutive Pro Bowls. Out of American Samoa, he's the very picture of intensity out there, and many regard him as one of the best linebackers of all time.
Third and 10. First down.
Ed McCaffrey had two guys on him and still made the catch, Dan. Oh, there it is. Man, you can't coach that.
Yeah, and with double coverage, I'm really surprised the pass came his way at all. Ball at the 34-yard line. Smith in motion. Davis with the ball. A gain of four.
Harry, this one just left of center and gets a few.
Single back formation. Creasy got the ball. Fourth down.
That's so frustrating for the receiver. He knows he should have caught it.
Elam lines up for the field goal and can put his team in the lead here in the fourth.
This through the uprights without too much hassle. Straight down the pipe.
Yeah, nice kick, and the special team squad is happy about that. They'd love to see it go smoothly, just as that one did. The Broncos, with that score, take the lead. They're up 5-3. Elam will kick this one away. White has it. There's a tackle.
Return of 22. First down, Chargers.
They would definitely like to score on this drive right here. There's not enough time left for mistakes.
Ball at the 17-yard line. Williams had to leave the Michelle Westfall has the full details. Michelle?
It looks like he just pulled a calf muscle down, and he's stretching it out on the sideline. He should be back later in the game.
Thanks, Michelle. Second and 10. They line up with their tight end left. Incompletion in a row.
Steven Alexander got some room in the middle, but couldn't make the catch.
Third and 10.
Hey, baby, keep going and keep the pass up. Hey,
Conway goes in motion.
Completion here. Take a look. There's the throw right in between the numbers.
He had them lined up just right, and they connected for a decent gain. It's first and 10. We've reached the two-minute warning. Ball on the 45.
Some good yards on that second down run.
2 yards to go.
It's third and 2.
Three and out. Three and out.
They're going with two wideouts. White in motion.
Tomlinson is all wound up right here, and let's move just in time. Watch this. Just before he gets wrapped up, a slick spin move puts him out of danger.
He pulled that move off at just the right time, Peter. That is a tough tackle for anyone. Ball at the 40-yard line. They line up in the eye. The Chargers still keep on the ground. Game of 3.
Carried this one off his left guard and picked up a handful.
7 yards to go.
It's second and about 7 yards. First time out.
They dump it off over the middle and complete it for a nice pickup off first down.
The clock is down to 8. Three, one shotgun. Throws. We'll bring up third and about a foot.
Delta O'Neal played off the ball well, and it fell incomplete.
Than a yard. Richie, and win it with this kick. Tremendous pressure down on the field right now. It's away. Good, it flies between the posts, and they'll add it to the scoreboard. The Chargers take the lead with that score, 6-5. Richie lines up for the kickoff. Strong kick. Casper fields it in the end zone. 20. There's the whistle, and that's the end of the game. The Chargers win a squeaker, 6-5. Well, that's all she wrote. Hey, everybody, on behalf of Peter O'Keefe, Michelle Westfall, and myself, Dan Stevens, thanks for tuning in. Stay tuned for the ESPN postgame wrap-up coming up next.
Thanks for joining us here on the ESPN postgame show. I'm Clark Dishman. The Chargers come away with a one-point squeaker over the Broncos. The Chargers did not give up many yards through the air, as the numbers plainly show us. Their defense kept the heat on the receivers for most of the game. Rodney Harrison shut down the pass with a total of one interception and four tackles. He's our ESPN player of the game. Well, that will do it for now. Make sure you tune into ESPN during the regular season for all the games, highlights, and insight. I'm Clark Dishman. We'll see you then.